On this video, we find the inverse f inverse of x for each of these one-to-one functions, and we also graph f of x equals 1/3 x plus 2 and its inverse on the same set of axes and make an observation about the graphs of inverses. This is part 11 of functions, and we're going to be finding inverse functions for one-to-one functions. So here's the first one. Find f inverse of x if f of x equals 1/3 x plus 2. Alright, so the steps are, first we're going to write f as y equals 1/3 x plus 2. So the step one is to write the function with replacing f of x with y. Next, we want to write what the inverse function would be. Well, for an inverse function, we switch the x and the y. So this will be x equals 1/3 y plus 2. Now, we need to get it back in function notation to write it as f inverse of x, so we need to solve for y. Now, what I'm going to do is write 1/3 y plus 2 equals x. That's really the same equation. I'm just switching what's on the left and right side. And now to solve for y, you've got various ways to do this. You could multiply both sides of the equation by 3, or you could subtract 2 from both sides first. It really doesn't matter. I'm going to multiply both sides by 3 so we get rid of the fraction. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 3. All right, so we have 3 times 1/3 y will just give us y. Plus, remember the side also has a plus 2, 3 times 2 is 6. So we have y plus 6 equals, and multiplying 3 on the other side gives us 3x. So to solve for y, subtract 6, and we have y equals 3x minus 6. But it says find f inverse of x. So the last step is to rewrite this in function notation, f inverse of x. So we replace y with f inverse of x is 3x minus 6, and now we have the inverse function. Now, both of these functions are lines, f of x and f inverse of x. If you wanted to graph these, what you could do is graph one, whatever's easiest for you, and then to get the other one, just switch all the ordered pairs, like switch three of the ordered pairs, and you'll have your new line. All right, here's another one. Find f inverse of x if f of x equals 3 over x minus 5. Why don't you try this on your own by putting the video on pause and then check and see if you get the same answer I do. All right, so we're going to start by rewriting f as y equals 3 over x minus 5. So we're replacing this f of x with a y, okay? So the inverse, we just switch the x and y coordinates. I'm sorry, the x and y variables. So x equals 3 over y minus 5. All right, now that is the inverse, but we want to write this as a function. And again, there's more than one way to solve this for y. To write it as a function, we need to solve for y. So what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by y minus 5. So think about multiplying both sides of the equations by y minus 5. So I'll have x times y minus 5 on the right. On the left side of the equation. But on the right-hand side, the y minus 5 will cancel. So I just have 3. So I'm trying to solve for y. So I could write xy minus 5x equals 3. Now, if this was, 5y minus 6, you would just add 6 to both sides. Here you need to add 5x to both sides. So this gives us xy equals 5x plus 3. You could write 3 plus 5x or xy plus 3. Last thing is divide by both sides by x. So that gives you your y. Y is equal to 5x plus 3 over x, but what we want to do is write that in function notation. So instead of writing y equals, we want to now replace the y with f inverse of x equals 5x plus 3 over x. Now, that's one way of writing it, but keep in mind, somebody else might divide both terms in the numerator by x. So 5x over x is 5 plus 3 over x. So that's another way of writing f inverse of x. So you just have to be careful if you write it a little bit differently than somebody else. You might just check and see, you know, using algebra if there's more than one way of writing it. The way I've written it with a box around it is it's all over one denominator. Here's one for you to try. Find f inverse of x if f of x equals the cube root of x minus 8. Put the video on pause and try it on your own first. All right, so how are we going to start? We want to replace f of x with y, right? And that's how we want to write the function f. So f is really y equals cube root of x minus 8. Now, to find f inverse of x, we need to exchange the x and the y. So x equals cube root of y minus 8 is f inverse. And now we need to solve for y. I'm going to go ahead and write x plus 8 equals cube root of y by just adding 8 to both sides. And to solve for y, I need to cube both sides. So I'm going to cube this side and cube this side. That gives me y equals x plus 8 cubed. All right, now, when you write it in functional notation, you've solved for y here, but you really want to think of it as y equals x plus 8 cubed, so you could replace that y with f inverse of x. So now we're replacing it with f inverse of x, replacing the y with f inverse of x equals x plus 8 cubed. Now, that can be simplified if you wanted to multiply out x plus 8 times x plus 8 times x plus 8, but I'm just going to go ahead and leave it like that for now. Here's another one for you to try. Find f inverse of x if f of x equals the fifth root of x minus 1. Put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, we're going to begin by writing the function f with y equals the fifth root of x minus 1, replacing f of x with y. So f inverse we get by exchanging the x and y. So x equals the fifth root of y minus 1. Now I want to solve for y. Well, I have a y minus 1 underneath this fifth root, so I want to raise each side to the fifth power to undo that fifth root. So that gives you x to the fifth equals, well, the fifth root of y minus 1 raised to the fifth power will just be what's underneath that fifth root, y minus 1. And now I could solve for y by adding 1 to both sides. X to the fifth plus 1 equals y. But we want to write it back in function notation, so you want to write this as y equals x to the fifth plus 1 and simply replace y with f inverse of x. And here we go. F inverse of x equals x to the fifth plus 1. I hope you did as well as I did. Now remember, if you put a number in for an ordered pair for f of x, you should get the reverse ordered pair in the inverse function. So just as a little check, when in f of x, if you put in 1 for x, you get the fifth root of 0, which is going to be 0. And so the question is, what if you put in 0, the y value here, in for x into the f inverse function? You'll get 1. So notice, if 1, 0 is on f of x, 0, 1 really is on f inverse of x. The first problem we did on this video was to find f inverse of x when f of x was 1/3 x plus 2. Now remember, you could think of that as a line, y equals 1/3 x plus 2. And if we look at the inverse function we got, it's also a line, y equals 3x minus 6. What I want you to do is graph both of these lines, in other words, graph f and f inverse of x, on the same set of axes. So put the video on pause and try that on your own set of axes. All right, these are the two lines I got. Now, the way I did it was I first graph f of x equals 1/3 x plus 2, the purple line, and then I took those three ordered pairs and I switched the x's and y's and I got three more ordered pairs and I drew f inverse of x. The interesting thing to note is that these are mirror images across this line y equals x. This is the line y equals x, and that's why at 3, 3, they don't switch at all. But imagine if you took a mirror right at this line and you flipped it, you would get the other line. All right, we'll be doing some more problems with inverses on the next video, including how to verify you have the correct inverse.